Hi friends, in this video I will discuss about the current affairs for the first week of December 2018, and the current affairs in this video are exclusively selected for the candidates appearing in the government jobs. In this video we have started with one new fact, that is fact sheet. So it's with the current affairs we will be giving you fact sheet that will be the additional information other than the current affairs. So I hope that you would like that, as it will give you an additional input for the current affairs and it will help you in memorizing the current affair. SEBI issues norms for interoperability among clearing corporations. With an aim to reduce trading cost, regulator SEBI came out with a framework for interoperability among clearing corporations, which will be operationalized by 1st June 2019. Interoperability framework will be applicable to all the recognized CCPs, excluding those operating in International Financial Services Center. At present, different brokers have their own CCPs which handle settlement of trades on the respective stock exchanges. The interoperability would permit trading members to clear trades through a firm of their choice instead of going through the CCP owned by the exchange on which the trade was executed. Now the fact sheet. Headquarters of SEBI is in Mumbai, and SEBI was established under SEBI Act 1992. And CEO is UK Sinha and chairman is Ajay Tyagi. World Gold Council appoints David Tate as new next CEO. The World Gold Council has appointed David Tate as Chief Executive Officer from next year. Tate will take over in February from Aram Sheshman, the Council CEO for the last decade. The World Gold Council has appointed David Tate as Chief Executive Officer from next year. Tate will take over in February from Aram Sheshmanian, the Council CEO for the last decade. Fact sheet. The World Gold Council is the market development organization for the gold industry. It works across all parts of the industry, from gold mining to investment, and their aim is to stimulate and sustain demand for gold. It was founded in 1987. South African President Cyril Ramaphosa to be 2019 Republic Day chief guest. South African President Cyril Ramaphosa will be chief guest at Delhi, India's 73rd Republic Day celebration. Fact sheet. First chief guest for Republic Day in 1950 was President Sukarno of Indonesia. In 2018, 10 guests from Asians were chief guests. FSSAI launches new campaign to eliminate trans fats by 2022. The Food Safety and Standard Authority of India launches a media campaign calling for the elimination of industrial produced trans fats in the food supply, named Heart Attack Rewind. The 32nd public service announcement, the first mass media campaign of its kind, will support FSSAI's global target of eliminating trans fats in India by 2022, a year ahead of the global target by the World Health Organization. It is in line with FSSAI's objective to get freedom from trans fat India at 75. Fact sheet. FSSAI is an autonomous body established under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India. Established in 2011 under the Food Safety and Standard Act 2006. Delhi Minister Imran Hussain gets PETA Hero to Animals Award for banning Chinese manja. Delhi Minister of Food Supplies, Environment and Forest and Election Imran Hussain was awarded by the people for the ethical treatment of animals India for banning the Chinese manja across Delhi on December 1st. Founded in March 1980, People for Ethical Treatment of Animal is an American criminal rights organization. It's headquartered in Norfolk, Virginia, in USA. Indian Navy Day celebrated on December 4. Indian Navy has Day is celebrated annually on December 4 every year. It is commemorated to honor the maritime operation by the Navy during the 1971 Indo-Pak War. The Maratha Emperor Chhatrapati Shivaji Bhosle is considered as father of the Indian Navy. Fact sheet: Chief of Naval Staff Admiral Sunil Lamba. Ex-IRDA Chief T.S. Vijayan appointed as Additional Director of Yes Bank Board. T.S. Vijayan, a former Chairman of Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority, has been appointed to its Board of Directors after a series of resignations. Fact sheet: Yes Bank Limited is a new generation private sector bank, was given. Yes Bank Limited is a new generation private sector bank, was given banking license in 2004. Yes Bank was in news this year after RBI denied to approve reappointment of its co-founder Rana Kapoor as MD and CEO. IL&FS appoints ex-L&T executive N. Sivaraman as Group COO. That legend infrastructure leasing and finance company has appointed N. Sivaraman as Group Chief Operating Officer. Fact sheet: A brainchild of the late M. J. Perwin, IL&FS was founded in 1987. IL&FS Financial Services, a group company, defaulted in payment obligations of banks, bank loans, term and short deposits, and failed to meet the commercial paper redemption obligation due on September 14. A board chaired by Uday Kotak took over the existing board of the company to stem IL&FS crisis after the government filed a case in the NCLT. Delhi Daredevils renamed as Delhi Capitals ahead of 2019 IPL season. Indian Premier League franchisee Delhi Daredevils were renamed Delhi Capital. The team is owned by GMR Group and JSW Sports. Qatar to withdraw from OPEC in January 2019. Qatar said it would quit OPEC from January to focus on its gas ambitions. Qatar, one of OPEC's smallest oil producer but the world's biggest liquefied natural gas exporter, is embroiled in a protracted diplomatic row with Saudi Arabia and some Arab states. The organizers of the petroleum exporting countries OPEC, founded in 1960 in Baghdad by the first five members, Iran, Iraq, Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, and Venezuela, headquartered in Vienna, Austria since 1965. Secretary General of OPEC, Mohammed Sanusi. 2020 FIFA World Cup is scheduled to be held in Qatar. Ministry of Railway signs an MOU with Madame Tussaud Wax Museum to foster tourism in Delhi NCR. Ministry of Railways, National Rail Museum and Madame Tussaud Wax Museum join hands together to provide an amazing combo offer to Delhi NCR tourists. Madame Tussaud's Wax Museum Delhi was opened on December 1, 2017. The original Madame Tussaud Wax Museum was founded by wax sculptor Mary Tussaud. India's first locomotive-less train Trans-18 crosses 180 km per hour speed limit. India's first locomotive-less train, known as Train 18, breached the 180 km per hour speed limit during a test run. Train 18 is capable of touching 200 kmph. When this indigenously designed train is made operational, it will become country's fastest train. With 16 coaches, the train will have the same passenger carrying capacity as that of Shatabdi Express. IIT Kharagpur, University of Auckland, Inc. packed off for research tie-up. IIT Kharagpur and University of Auckland signed a pact to foster academic exchange and research collaboration. As per the Memorandum of Understanding, the first strategic partnership of University of Auckland with a higher education in India, the two educational establishments would explore opportunities for research in healthcare technologies, new materials, cybersecurity, and artificial intelligence. December 1st is observed as World AIDS Day. World AIDS Day, designated on 1st December every year, is an international day dedicated to raising awareness of the AIDS pandemic caused by the spread of HIV infections and mourning of those who have died of the disease. The theme for the World AIDS Day 2018 is Know Your Status. Dr. Krishnamurthy Subramaniam appointed new Chief Economic Advisor. The government appointed Dr. Krishnamurthy Subramaniam, Associate Professor of Indian School of Business, Hyderabad, as the new Chief Economic Advisor. He has taken the place of Arvind Subramaniam, who resigned from the post on June 20 this year. Karnataka gets permission for Mekedatu project. Central Water Commission has given approval to Karnataka's disputed Mekedatu project on River Kaveri. Mekedatu is a deep gorge situated 100 km away from Bengaluru. Third ASEAN-India Business Summit took place in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Third ASEAN-India Business Summit was organized by the ASEAN-India Business Council, Malaysian chapter in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It was organized under the guidance of Ministry of International Trade and Industry. Spice Garden Group of Restaurants owner Pradeep Patra was awarded the special ASEAN India Achievement Award for the Business of the Year. Fact sheet: ASEAN was founded on August 8, 1967, and it is headquartered at Jakarta, Indonesia. Global Agriculture and Food Summit 2018 held in Jharkhand. Union Agriculture Minister Radha Mohan Singh inaugurated the two-day Global Agriculture and Food Summit in Ranchi, Jharkhand. The focus of the summit was organic farming. NGT appoints former High Court Judge UC Dhyani to monitor Ganga cleaning. The National Green Tribunal has appointed former Uttarakhand High Court Justice UC Dhyani as head of the three-member committee to oversee rejuvenation work of the Ganga River. Fact sheet: the National Green Tribunal has been established on October 18, 2010, under the NGT Act 2010. Carlsen retain world-class championship title. World number one Norwegian Magnus Carlsen has retained his world chess championship title, beating US opponent Fabiano Quirino in a tiebreaker event. The Norwegian is ranked number one worldwide for fast-paced games, whereas Quirino is ranked at number 18. Sri Arvind Saxena appointed as Chairman UPSC. The president has appointed Shri Arvind Saxena as chairman UPSC. Shri Arvind Saxena joined UPSC as a member on May 8, 2015 and has been performing duties of the post of chairman UPSC since June 2018. Prior to joining UPSC as member, Shri Saxena was working as director of the Aviation Research Center ARC. Fact sheet: UPSC was founded on October 1, 1926. NASA's InSight spacecraft successfully lands on Mars. NASA's spacecraft InSight lander successfully landed on Mars. After the 6-month journey, InSight will study the interior of Mars and will inform about valuable science as NASA prepared to send astronauts to the moon and later to the Mars. India to host G20 summit in 2022, 75th year of independence. Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced that India will host the G20 summit in 2022. The year of country would celebrate the 75th anniversary of its independence. The G20 is a grouping of the world's 20 major economies. International Gita Festival 2018 to be held in Kurukshetra, Haryana. The International Gita Festival 2018 will be organized in Kurukshetra in Haryana from December 7 to 23, 2018. This year it is third year of this mega cultural events where Mauritius is partner country and Gujarat is partner state. The objective behind this event is to spread the message of Gita to world. It is being organized to commemorate birth of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. It is held mainly on 11th day of Shukla Paksha or of Margshirsh month in November or December. Renowned flautist Keshav Ginde conferred with Pandit Bhimsen Joshi Award. Renowned flautist Pandit Keshav conferred this year's prestigious Pandit Bhimsen Joshi Lifetime Achievement Award. This is an annual award instituted by Maharashtra, honors maestros in classical music and singing, and carries a cash award of Rs. 5 lakh, a memento, and a citation. Country's first oval festival held in Pune. The Indian Oval Festival, the country's first oval fest, will be held at Pingori village in Purandar, Taluka of Pune, Maharashtra. The 2-day festival organized by ILLA Foundation. It will give information on oval conservation and feature art reform forms like pictures, paintings, lanterns, lampshades, posters, origami, stitches, articles, and poems and stories on ovals. NGT slapped Rs. 5 crore fine on West Bengal government for failing to curb air pollution. The National Green Tribunal has slapped a Rs. 5 crore fine on the West Bengal government for failing to comply with its 2-year-old directive to improve air quality in Kolkata and Howrah. A.S. Rajiv appointed MD and CEO of Bank of Maharashtra. Shri A.S. Rajiv has been appointed as Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Bank of Maharashtra. Shri Rajiv is having about 3 decades of professional experience in 3 banks. Syndicate Bank, Vijaya Bank, and Indian Bank. Blue Waters Ahoy chronicling the Indian Navy's history from 2001 to 2010. Admiral Sunil Lamba released a book titled Blue Waters Ahoy chronicle the Indian Navy's history from 2001 to 10. The book has been authored by Vice Admiral Anoop Singh, who retired as the Flag Officer Commanding in Chief of Eastern Naval Command in 2011. Indian Navy to conduct exercise Sea Vigil to test robustness of coastal security apparatus. The Indian Navy will conduct a large-scale coastal defense exercise next month to test the robustness of the entire coastal security apparatus. Theater-level operational readiness exercise, or TROPEX, will begin from January 2019 and will culminate in March 2019. Ajay Narayan Jha takes over as Finance Secretary. Shri Ajay Narayan Jha was appointed the new Finance Secretary. Jha, a 1982 batch IAS officer of Manipur Tripura Cadre, succeeds Hansmukh Adia, who retired on November 30. The senior most secretary in the Finance Ministry is normally designated as the Finance Secretary. Cabinet approves implementation of Shahpur Kandi Dam on River Ravi in Punjab. The Union Cabinet chaired by Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi has appointed implementation of Shahpur Kandi Dam project Punjab on River Ravi. Implementation of this project would help minimizing some of the water of the River Ravi, which at present is going west through the Madhopur headworks downstream to Pakistan. India-UAE signed currency swap deal. UAE and India has inked a currency swap agreement, which means businesses can now trade using local currencies of rupee and dirham instead of dollar. Currency swap, it is a pact between two countries that allows trading in their own currencies and payments to import and export trades at a predetermined exchange rate without bringing in a third benchmark currency like the US dollar. Ambedkar Mahaparinirvan Divas 2018. Ambedkar Mahaparinirvan Divas 2018. Dr. Ambedkar died on this day in 1956, and therefore December 06 is observed as Mahaparinirvan Divas every year. This year, the 63rd Dr. Ambedkar Divas was observed. Shri Sunil Arora takes over as new Chief Election Commissioner of India. Shri Sunil Arora assumed charge as the 23rd Chief Election Commissioner of India, succeeding Shri O.P. Rawat. Shri Arora, a former IAS officer of Rajasthan Cadre 1980 batch. Prior to assuming charge as Chief Election Commissioner, Shri Arora had been serving as Election Commissioner in Election Commission of India since 1st September 2017. PM Modi most followed world leader on Instagram. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has emerged as the most popular global leader on social media platform Instagram with 14.8 million followers. According to a list published by online platform Diplomacy, Modi is closely followed by Indonesian President Joko Widodo with 12.2 million followers. With 10 million followers, US President Donald Trump is at the third position on photo sharing platform. Gautam Gambhir announces retirement from all forms of cricket. Former Indian opening batsman Gautam Gambhir has announced his retirement from all forms of cricket, saying his time to continue with the game is over. Armed Forces Flag Day 2018. Since 1949, December 07 is observed as Armed Forces Flag Day throughout India to honor the martyrs as well as men and women in uniform. The Armed Forces Flag Day Fund has been constituted by the Government of India for the welfare and rehabilitation of the ex-serviceman community. ISRO's heaviest satellite GSAT-11 successfully launched from French Guiana. India's most advanced high-throughput communication satellite GSAT-11 was successfully launched from spaceport in French Guiana. The satellite weighs 5,854 kg GSAT-11 and is the heaviest satellite ever built by the Indian Space Research Organization. Some facts: GSAT-11 will boost the broadband connectivity to rural and inaccessible gram panchayats in the country, coming under the Bharat Net project, which is a part of Digital India program. The Bharat Net project aims to enhance the public welfare schemes like e-banking, e-health, e-governance, among others. ASU launches world's first GST calculator. Japanese electronic company KSU has launched world's first goods and service tax calculator in India for simplifying the GST calculations for taxpayers. These new GST calculators will provide solutions for GST-based invoicing. The GST calculator features inbuilt in GST tabs for all 5 slabs 0, 5, 12, 18, and 28. It includes separate buttons for GST slabs to reduce time required for processing invoice. GST was launched in India from July 1st, 2017. Wipro Chairman Azim Premji conferred with highest French civilian honor. Chairman of IT major Wipro and philanthropist Azim Premji was bestowed with highest French civilian distinction, Chevalier de la Legion d'Honneur, Knight of the Legion of Honor. He was awarded for his outstanding contribution to developing information technology industry in India, his economic outreach in France, and his contribution to society as philanthropist through the Azim Premji Foundation and Azim Premji University. National Mission for Clean Ganga plans to set up Ganga Museum. The National Mission for Clean Ganga is planning to set up a Ganga exhibition at a Ganga Museum for public outreach in New Delhi. Maharashtra government has approved 16% Maratha reservation. Marathas community in Maharashtra will now be able to get 16% reservation in government jobs and education in the state. With this move, the caste reservation quota in the state will now reach 68% from the existing 52%. Andaman hosts first ever Indo-Indonesian Business Forum as part of Indo-Pacific strategies. The first ever India-Indonesian Business Forum would be held at Port Blair in Andaman and Nicobar Island as part of policies of Delhi and Jakarta to expand their strategic partnership in the Indo-Pacific region, including Indian Ocean region. The forum aims to facilitate the commercial and people-to-people linkages between Andaman and Nicobar Islands of India with SA and North Sumatra province of Indonesia. To solve Bengaluru's problem, the Karnataka government launches Data City program. The government of Karnataka has partnered with France-based utility company Suez, Bengaluru Water Supply and Sewerage Board, and Paris Headquarters Innovation Hub, NUMA, to launch Data City Open Innovation Program in collaboration with the startups and corporates. This was the current affairs for the first week of December 2018. Though there were some technical issues and there were some blackouts in the video, I'm sorry for that. That will not happen in the next videos. Thanks for watching. And if you liked my video, please don't forget to like, comment, and share my videos. Your comments, your feedbacks, and your likes matters a lot to me. It encourages me to make more good videos for all of you. Thank you for watching once again.